Hi, and welcome back to my Brackish aquarium. This experiment's been a lot of fun so far. One of the neat things is when I do go out and catch some of the fish, when I come back and add them to the tank with maybe some rocks or some shell, I found that I found brought back different species I didn't know I had. My eyebrow barnacle blenny, I didn't know I had him till I got back. He came back in a barnacle. One of the darter gobies, I didn't know I had him. A few of the other little species in here, tiny crabs and different snails, I didn't know I had them till I saw them, because they come in just so tiny. One of the things I was hoping to find, though, would be a bristle worm. Now, it's not something you really find. You just kind of have to hope to bring it home on some rock or something. And I did. Actually, I can see two with the naked eye on the front of the glass of the tank. So I'm sure if I can see two of them, I have many more. Now I'll show you the one guy here. This is him right here. Now I can get him to move by turning the light on. There he goes. Zoop. He's going to run and hide down there. Now, I figure he's a good 2-3 inches long. The other guy, the other bristle worm, he lives over, or I see him around about here. And he's about the same size. So if I can see two of them, you know there's quite a few more. And that's great because, you know, they live very far down in the substrate. And they eat, you know, and they come up and they eat some of the loose particles and the food and the debris that some of the other species can't get to. And as you saw, they go way down all the way to the bottom of the substrate. Which is great because they break up the rock and they keep, you know, gas pockets from happening. And they do all kinds of actual beneficial things. Eventually, if they get too big, I might have to get them out. But I kind of like it. I think it's cool. It's a very very real going on in the tank. You know, I have barnacles. I have bristle worms. I have, you know, all kinds of neat things in there. A couple of other things I've noticed going on. I'm going to have to wait to see what happens. One, I have barnacles starting to grow on my rock, which I think is very cool. Having my own barnacles grow. When these get a little bigger, I'll point them up. But on this rock here, I've got a couple little ones, and they've started to grow. And I think that's really neat. You know, I'm almost tempted to you know, get rid of the fish and just kind of keep this, you know, snails and, you know, some of the more interesting species like that. One of the fun things also is feeding these fish, and that's been a chore too. I've had to get rid of a lot of the gambusia because they eat everything, and they eat nonstop. And no matter how much food you put in the tank, they'll eat it. So my needlefish were dying, my pipefish, excuse me, were dying. I lost all but two. Since I've gotten rid of them, they're thriving. And I also added some more food. I got some carnivore pellets, sinking pellets, and the flounder love them. They really do, and they're thriving off of them, and they look a lot happier now. So I'm learning step by step on, you know, how to do this. I'm mostly learning from the mistakes I've made. But if everyone in here is happy and, you know, everyone's healthy, that's really cool. You know, a few of the other things I'll try and figure out what they are, but it looks like I have not just barnacles growing, but a couple of anemones, certain types of anemones growing on some pieces of coral and also the rock. Once they get a little bigger and I identify them, I'll make a video showing those guys. So this has been really neat, not just going and catching the fish, but also finding out what else I've brought home. You know, I'm sure the bristle worms were very small when they were put in the tank. I couldn't see them with the naked eye. And they're thriving. So that's pretty neat. Just wanted to give an update. And show you how well this is going. I like this. You know, one of the things is it's a 10-gallon tank and it's so small. And a lot of the species I have in here, I see people, they keep them, they say, oh, don't keep that in less than a 25-gallon tank. And I'm you know, they're alive, but, you know, I don't know how happy they are about it. So eventually I want to move this over. I have a 35-gallon tank, and I want to move this over to that. But since I've made so many mistakes from the beginning, and I'm learning so much and so quickly, I'm going to keep this going for a little while. Learn from my mistakes, try and correct them, get this going to a stable habitat. And from there, when I feel confident enough, I'll move this over to the larger tank. That way I can get some more species. Like I said, the river has puffer fish and all kinds of interesting critters in there. So, like I said, this has all been a learning curve for me, and it's an experiment at best. If anybody has any advice or any help they could give me, or tell me you know, what I'm doing wrong, I'd be grateful. Thank you very much, and I hope you enjoy this because I do. And I'll leave you with a couple minutes of the tank and enjoy. Have a good one.